In part three of the obstacle course game, we'll take our three-dimensional obstacle course from the previous parts and turn it into a two-dimensional map that we can use to talk about our path through the course. Mapmaking is an important skill for preschoolers to practice. When children create their own maps, they're building up their spatial reasoning skills. For this part of the game, you'll need the same obstacle course that you used in parts 1 and 2, as well as the spatial word cards and some art supplies like paper, crayons, pencils, or markers. To get started with this part, you can say, "You finished the obstacle course. Now we're going to draw a map of the obstacle course and use it to help us walk through the course one last time." And children may be ready to draw their own map, but if not, give them as much help as they need, or you can even do the drawing in this portion of the game. Once we have our map, we'll use our spatial word cards to describe and draw the path we took through the course. So at the wooden arch, we went under, and we'll use our under spatial card to help remind us of that, and we'll draw an arrow like this to show under. Then at the second item, the stack of cups, I remember that we went around. So we'll draw a curved arrow like this to show around. Then at the caterpillar, I remember that we went over. So I draw an arrow over the caterpillar on my map. And then finally, we went inside the shoe, which I can draw like this. Now that we have our course and our path through the course mapped out, you can have children go back to the physical obstacle course and use their map to help them navigate through it. So if it's a big course, the child would hold their map, or in the case of our mini course, we'll put the map right here. And we can move through the course, remembering that we went under the arch, around the cup, over the caterpillar, and inside the shoe. At each step of the obstacle course, you can ask questions like, "What does your map say to do at the arch? Does it say to go over or under the arch?" Then they can look at their map and see that they drew an arrow underneath the arch, and they'll know to go under the arch. Once each child has gone through the obstacle course one last time, you can either clean up or build a new course. You can continue helping kids with their map-making skills by pointing out maps that you find out in the world, like on the bus or in stores or in parks. As you walk around, talk to children about how the objects and landmarks they see all around them correspond to points on the map.